when Jim was president, we had the American River Foundation, and we did a really great project where we did a lot of shoveling and carrying of seemed like bricks, but actually they were stones, and it ended my husband up in the hospital for a surgery. But nothing is too good for Rotary, so. But it was a wonderful project, and I got to meet Jordan Powell, our speaker this evening. So I'm very excited that he gets to be here and come back. So he's the volunteer coordinator of the Parkland Foundation. He coordinates the efforts of more than 6,000 volunteers. I was amazed that they even have that many volunteers at the Parkway Foundation. Jordan moved to Sacramento from Maryland in 2015 by way of North Carolina. That's where he went to school. He received a bachelor's in international politics and broadcast journalism, which of course would make you want to go work at a American Parkway Foundation. So we talked about that at dinner. He's currently a member of the Nehemiah Emerging Leaders Program in Sacramento. In his spare time, he enjoys reading, hiking, and then he said that he pretends that he's a music and film critic. It's my pleasure to introduce Jordan Powell.
Thank you. Thanks, Ann, and thanks everyone for having me tonight. It's wonderful to be here. This is quite a lively crew that we have, and I love to see that. So I'm going to talk for a little bit about the American River Parkway Foundation, which is an organization that I'm sure many of you are familiar with, and if not, I'm confident that you're familiar with the American River Parkway. And if that's not the case, we'll go for a walk. I'll be there in 90 seconds, and I'll show you where it is. But Ann said I have the floor until about 9 o'clock. Is that right? All right, we got some life. I'm going to keep this pretty informal and then open up for questions, but I'll talk for a little bit about the American River Parkway and why I think it's such an important asset to the region. You know, if you're Sacramentans born and bred, you're probably familiar with the Parkway and you love it, but I'm going to highlight some of the things that I love about it that maybe you haven't thought about before and things that we emphasize, and then I'll talk a little bit about the Parkway Foundation. Otherwise, I would lose my job probably if I didn't do that. So anyways, the American River Parkway is a public park system, of course. It spans along 23 miles of the American River. So as soon as you cross the dam at the fish hatchery, you've entered state park land, and that's on the other side of that bridge at Hazel Avenue. That's state park. So the American River Parkway is a county-owned portion of that land from Hazel Avenue down to Discovery Park. 23 miles of river, it's about 4,800 acres total. And so if you think of the biggest parks, the most famous parks in the country, in the world, Central Park comes to mind. The American River Parkway is about 27 times as big as Central Park in New York. When folks come to Sacramento, they see the Parkway, they visit the Parkway. I like to think of the benefits of the Parkway to Sacramento in sort of three main pillars. The first, of course, being recreation. It's such a recreational asset that we have here, right? You think of all of the users of the Parkway that we have every year. You have hikers, you have runners, you have walkers, people walking their dogs, fishing, boating, kayaking, paddling, cycling, everything in between, bird watching. So, in an effort not to lose everyone this early on, how many visits do we think the Parkway gets every year? We'll have a couple guesses. I'll be giving away a couple of these Parkway maps for folks that are willing to participate for me here. So how many visits to the Parkway every year? That means if you go 8 times, that counts as 8 visits.
6 billion.
Billion with a B is a little high, but it's a good guess.
40,000.
40,000?
2 million.
All right, I think I heard 2.5 up front, which I think was the closest. It's 8 million.
Wow.
8 million visits a year, which, I mean, that's incredible. I'm not a math guy, but if you think about 365 days in a year, yeah.
I was told years ago that it's the second most visited park in California after Golden Gate Park in San Francisco.
You know, I don't know how many visits Golden Gate gets, but I know that the Parkway gets twice as many visits a year as Yosemite does. And so that wouldn't surprise me if that were true. Like I said, I don't know the stats for Golden Gate, but definitely the Yosemite gets about 4 million visits, 3.5 million visits every year, and the Parkways have at 8 million. And that was calculated about 4 years ago, so it's probably significantly up from then. So that's recreational benefits. Obviously, you think about the benefits to your health of recreating and using your bike and going out and being on the river, all that. I don't need to harp upon that. The second one is economic benefit, the economic benefit to Sacramento of having this 5,000-acre park system that runs right through the heart of the city. Another guessing game, the Sacramento County has estimated a value benefit to the county of the economics. You think about property values close to the river, you think about hotels that are drawing in large conventions and large business complexes that are near the river. You think about, drawing businesses and industries in because of the access to the river. So what do we think that number is on an annual basis? Economic, financial value to Sacramento County?
$200 million.
$200 million, that's a good guess. I'll give it there, that's $365 million a year of economic benefit. Again, estimated about 4 years ago, so think about that being significantly higher now. So that's the economic benefits again. Not something I want to really harp upon too much, but it is incredible, and it's a huge draw, particularly for those things like I mentioned, hotels, real estate, drawing in businesses. There's tons of studies out there about how folks, new home buyers, are wanting to buy near a public park, a public green space, somewhere where they can get out and enjoy fresh air, much more so than in previous generations. And so having the parkway here is a huge draw for a lot of those folks. All right, and the third benefit, which I think is the most important, is the public health benefits of having the parkway. I talked about the benefits to your physical health, of course, with the recreating, the running, the cycling, but you think about the benefits to mental health. There's dozens, hundreds of studies out there about youth in particular and getting youth access to public green space and out in nature and how that can have a positive impact on their mental development and their mental health overall. Lots of folks nowadays I have found are writing green prescriptions. I'm not from Sacramento or California. I think in this state that might mean something a little bit different, but on a global scale, a green prescription is simply a script to spend time outdoors, spend an hour a day, an hour a week outdoors. And that's actually written by a doctor because of the proven mental and physical health benefits of that. So having that, again, running through the main vein of the city is really an incredible thing that we have. And getting folks to use it, encouraging folks to use it, and especially children, is such an important part of being a Sacramentan, in my opinion. So those are some of the benefits of having the parkway, why I think the parkway is so important, and why I think, transitioning now to what the foundation does, why it's important to sort of care about keeping it up. I find it's pretty easy to convince folks to care about the parkway, and so that makes my job pretty easy to get them to come out and do work, because everyone, once you go out there once, you fall in love with it. Not too hard. So I'm going to break down what the Parkway Foundation does into three as well. I don't know what my attraction is to the number three, but it sort of, I guess, helps compartmentalize my brain a little bit. I dropped flyers on everyone's table, so I'm not going to read off our mission statement or anything like that. I think I might have missed a table up front. You can look through that. It has all of our programs that we run on there. It has our mission and our vision on there and some of our special events. Again, I'm not going to run through that because I want you to look at that later, take it home, peruse our website. But those three pillars I was talking about, sort of what we stand for, again, is recreation, we have education, and we have conservation. So recreation, a big part of what we do and what I love about the Parkway Foundation is just encouraging people to use and access the parkway. Because if people don't use it, then it'll just fall into disarray and nobody will care about it. So we want to get people out there, we want to get people cycling, we want to get people running, we want to get people bird watching. So we have a couple special events that we do to promote that, the usage of the parkway, the recreating on the parkway. We have a cycling event that we put on every September, and we have a running event now that we put on in November. And also, as far as recreation, the running trails, if you're ever out on the dirt trails, Or if you're ever walking and you don't want to get hit by a cyclist coming at you 25 miles per hour, so you veer off onto the dirt path, we do all the trail maintenance on those trails. So we keep those trails. There's one main trail that we're permitted to keep 6 feet wide, 8 feet high, so that you can walk on that trail and not worry about any rattlesnakes sneaking up on you or anything like that. So we do trail maintenance on that, and also really are just promoting the recreational use of the parkway. The second pillar, which I mentioned, is conservation, I think. And conservation, of course, that's sort of our lifeblood. We were founded to offer conservation volunteer programs on the parkway, and that's a big part of what we do. You're probably familiar with our cleanups program. That's the main program that I run, is our river cleanups. Our volunteers clear out 50,000 pounds of trash in 2016. And so that's a huge program that we're running and a huge volunteer effort that folks are undertaking. We have five of us that work full-time at the Parkway Foundation, so if we did it all ourselves, we'd be working about 1,000 acres each. And so that's why we have 6,000 volunteers that help us do that. But then outside of that program, we have a really, really robust invasive plant management program. Those volunteers are pulling out almost 100,000 plants a year, and this isn't Bermuda grass, this is trees and shrubs and bushes that you have to put in some elbow grease to yank out of the ground. So that's our invasive plant management program. We have a wildfire restoration program and tons of other opportunities. I'm running short on time here, so I'm gonna let you all ask questions about that if you like. But that last pillar I have is education, and that's one that we're really, over the last couple years, have started to push to the forefront. It's something we're really excited about. We have a new program that's about 2 years old called our Campfire Outdoor Education Program. It just came to maturity almost this year, where we ran a full year with this program. The Sacramento County Office of Education offers a curriculum at a site that we host on the Parkway, and this past year they had 3,000 students from Title I schools that came out to this class. I got to audit one of the classes. It was incredible. The kids were from Elk Grove. They never knew the river even existed. They were running around. They saw a dead skunk. They thought it was awesome. I thought it was disgusting. And they were learning all these cool things about the pioneers that landed in Sacramento in California, and the gold rush, and how they forged the river, and all these really cool things that the kids were learning. That's a program that we love and we're looking to really expound upon. And Title I schools, those are schools that are, the majority of kids at that school are receiving benefits, receiving free or reduced lunch benefits. And so those are from impoverished communities or from low-income communities. That's what a Title I school is. So we're really excited about that. And then a new program, a very brand new program we have, is called Recreate for Health. And it's sort of combining those two elements that I was talking about, the importance of recreation and the importance of public health on the Parkway. So we've been working with a couple organizations that work with previously incarcerated youth or foster youth that are aging out, getting them out on the Parkway, not only to recreate, to teach them that it's a good way to get to and from places, but also to learn some hard skills. So we've been teaching some bike labs, so teaching them how to repair and fix bicycles, maybe a skill they can use to get a job. We've had B Street Theater come out and do a public speaking class out there. So really trying to institute some learning, soft and hard skills that folks, that youth can use while also learning to love the Parkway. So those are my 1, 2, 3. I'll go, ways to get involved. There's tons of volunteer opportunities. That's kind of my whole shtick. So if you want to talk to me about that, certainly can do that. That run that I was talking about is a good opportunity for big groups to come and participate in a fun event, handing out waters to the runners. That's in November. But throughout the year, across all of those programs, we have opportunities for volunteers. And then we have special events that we run also for volunteers, or if your business wants to get involved. One thing I do want to highlight that's on your flyer there is a program called our Parkway Partners. This is something we've really, again, started to develop as we've grown the last few years, to develop partnerships with local businesses to do some cross-promotion. So we're trying to promote businesses that are supporters of the Parkway, but that are also near the Parkway. So if someone's on the river and they look at our website, they're like, where can I go? I'm in Fair Oaks, where can I go? We want to have partner businesses in all of those communities that the river runs through that we can say, all right, you want to go get a sandwich and a beer? Go grab that here in Fair Oaks. Hop across the bridge, here's how you get there. Or you're riding your bike on Fair Oaks and you realize there's a lot going on in Fair Oaks that you love. Here's a couple of real estate agents that live in Fair Oaks that might want to help you out. So that's a cool program that we're trying to promote local businesses. With that said, I know folks always have lots of questions, so let's jump into questions here.
Thank you.
She's had her hand up for a while. Yeah, what's up?
So I guess it's changed a lot, but quite a few years ago, I avoided the parkway because of crime and violence. What has made it better?
Yeah, so over the last few years, the Rangers, the Ranger staff has increased significantly. I think last year they doubled the number of Rangers that they had for Sacramento County Parks. I think the year before that they doubled as well. And this upcoming year, they're going to be doubling the number of Rangers again. So just that presence has helped with that. I think there's just been an increased awareness. Certainly, there are still parts of the parkway that I don't encourage folks to go to after dark. But anytime during the daytime, I've never had any issues. And so I think that is because there's some Rangers that have been hired new and also some that have been working in the same areas for a long time. My experience is Rangers that have their adopted area, they know all the folks that are out there. They develop relationships with them and all that.